My name's Gordon Dedman, and welcome to another episode of Bushcraft Survival. Today we're going to be lighting a fire using a friction method known as the bow drill. Before we light any type of fire, we must make sure our fire lay and preparation is all done ahead of time. As always, we have our platform of parallel sticks, matchstick size kindling, pencil stick size kindling, little finger size, right up to thumb thickness and beyond. Very important to have our preparation done ahead of time. The tinder we're using to light our fire today is a combination of paper bark from the melaleuca tree and cabbage palm fibre. I've mixed those two together to make a nice tinder bundle, also known as a bird's nest. The bow drill method of friction fire lighting is a North American method, and the components of the set that we use to make that fire are as follows. First of all, we have our bow with some cordage. We have our half board. We have a spindle or drill, our handhold, and our ember pan. Looking at the bow firstly, any kind of wood is fine for the bow, and it doesn't matter if it can be straight, it can be slightly curved, it will work with straight wood. And I've got some cordage here. Now this is the limiting factor in the bow drill, because if you don't have cordage, you have to make it, and you need to be able to make it strong enough to withstand the forces that are going to be exerted upon it when we're actually using this method. In this case, I'm using some 550 parachute cord, and that's tightened up here. You could use a shoelace, a hem from your shirt, turn that into cordage, and you could also use that if it came to that. That's our bow. The half board and the drill need to be made from the same type of wood. Once again, for any friction method, we need a nice light balsa type wood. In Australia, grass tree or the Xantharia species. Today, I'm using a native coastal hibiscus. I've pre-cut this and dried it. In this area, lantana is another good option. However, I couldn't find any dead stuff. I've cut some down, I'm gonna dry that out, and I'm gonna do another video using lantana. The drill is like a pencil. Sharp at one end for less friction, blunt at the other end for greater friction. The half board we have flattened out at the top, and I'm going to show you how we actually set and seat the drill into the half board in a moment. The other part of the set is our ember pan. That's going to collect our dust, our powder, all the ember after we've drilled into our half board. And the last part of the set is our handhold, and that prevents the drill from drilling into my hand and allows me to exert downward pressure on that drill. Today, I could use any sort of wood for that, a hardwood preferably. But what I've found, a nice piece of old vertebrae from a dead animal that's got a nice indentation there to receive the tip of the drill. So that's what I'm going to be using today. Firstly, I haven't notched this yet. What I'm going to do is get my knife, and in the base of the board, notice how I've got this flattened out. One end, on a nice flat surface. What I'm doing, I'm just carving a depression into our half board, and that's going to receive our drill. And that's where we're going to drill into the set. We're not going to be going for a coal just yet. I'm just simply seating the drill. Because this cordage is new, and it's the first time I use it on this bow, it's going to stretch quite a bit. So I'm going to have to undo this a few times to get this to the right tension before we actually go for a coal. And that will happen when you use new cordage. So the technique, even though we're not going for a coal first, is to have my shin pushed forward, the corner of my wrist buried into my shin, and that's going to prevent lateral movement. Now remember, I'm not going for a cold yet, I'm just simply seating the drill. And nice strokes. I try to keep that drill as horizontal, keeping it parallel to the ground, I should say the bow, and nice even strokes. Smoke's starting to come out of the bottom already. And as you can see, I've just made a nice depression where the drill has married up with the set. Now I can notch that. To notch that, I can use my knife. But with the Swiss Army knives, they have actually a beautiful saw that actually cuts and works very, very well. And all I'm going to do is cut a little triangle into that. Now, normally I just use my knife, but I'm going to use a saw just to make it a little bit faster, because sometimes you mightn't have a saw out in the bush. And with my knife, I'm just going to tidy that up a little bit. I don't want any rough edges because the ember will tend to collect on those. I'm trying to smooth it out as best I can. And underneath the end of it, I like to bevel the underside of the notch of this carve. And what that does, it allows oxygen or air to get in underneath and get to that ember nice and quick, which is going to help bring that ember to life a bit faster. And there you can see, I've carved the notch into there. And that's where the powder is going to fall and collect on our ember pan, and then we're going to transfer that to our awaiting tinder bundle. Make sure you put away your tools. So we're going to be ready to go for a coal now. So what I'm doing, I've got my ember pan down, very important, because that's going to collect our ember. Here, the kookaburra is going in the background. And I'm just going to sharpen this a little bit more because we've just blunted that up a bit. You always want this nice and sharp, or as close to it as possible, because we don't want any friction at that end. Because it's soft wood, it's inevitable that's going to actually wear down and crush, but we just want to keep that to a minimum. I can feel our drill is starting to get a bit loose, but I'm going to see if I can produce a coal without that anyway. I may have to stop and tighten this drill because it is, the cordage is new and it is tending to stretch. If I had a piece of wood here, I can lubricate this indentation with a bit of green grass or some wax of some description, some resin. But because I'm using bone, I don't actually have to do that. Whatever case, this needs to be hard and smooth. Once again, my wrist is nicely firm against my shin. I'm looking at my posture. My weight is bearing down here. I'm not going to go too heavy first off. I'm just going to go nice and light. And then when it starts to bite, I increase the pressure and increase the speed until we get a lot of smoke, and that's going to produce our ember. Just starting off nice and easy. We have smoke. Try to do long, smooth strokes. Okay. and we have a cold. Our bow was just starting to slip with our cordage. We managed to get a cold just despite that. Quite often when you start with a new one, that's what happens. It will slip and you have to tighten it up. Give it a couple of goes until you get the right tension. There we go. And that's our wood powder. And I'm going to take that, transfer it to our tinder bundle. I've got a bit of time. I don't need to rush this. This is why it's very important to have your file, prepared. I'm going to take my tinder bundle, as we said, which is a mixture of paper bark and cabbage palm fibres. I'm going to take my coal, drop it in there, being very careful that it drops in the right place, and gently I wrap that around that. And there we have fire. I turn that upside down to let the flames go upwards because they want to move upwards. Let that establish itself. And take some of these small twigs I've got. I'm just gently putting those on top. I'm going to split this in two. Crisscross that over the top. And as always, when the flames come through the top, it's only then that I add my next layer of kindling. Very important not to do it too soon or we just smother the fire. So there are a few little twigs, so I can just put those around it. I accidentally dropped. Those flames have come through the top. I'm going to take my next grade of kindling. I'm going to crisscross that over the top. Once again, very important, as you can see, I've cleared the area so it's completely safe from bushfires. Always clear down to the bare ground and at least a 2 meter radius out from the center of the fire. Very, very important. Once the flames come through the top, I'm going to add my next layer of kindling. And what I can do from there is take my other grades and in teepee fashion, just lay them around the fire. What I have here is an established fire. I can go away and leave this now, at least for 5 minutes, 5-10 minutes, and get more wood if I need. But my preparation was good. So that allows me to actually get a fire going quickly, and I've done that in 5 minutes. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this episode on how to light a fire using the bow drill method. My name's Gordon Dedman, and I look forward to seeing you again on another episode of Bushcraft Survival.